Hello everyone, welcome to another session. Today we're going to talk about test data, which is a default data source available in every Grafana version. And basically it means that if you are new to Grafana and you don't know how to connect or don't have any resources to connect your Grafana to any data source, you can simply use it and play along with Grafana and learn it. So let's get started. My name is Usman Ahmed, and I work at Grafana Labs as a senior developer advocate. And I have been in the IT industry for more than 15 years and just wanted to share my knowledge and experience with you guys. And if you'd like to more about me, you can scan this QR code and you can contact me, ask me any questions regarding Linux or Grafana. I will be very happy to help as much as possible. So today, this is our agenda. So first of all, what is test data? So basically, test data is a, as said, that it's a default data source available in every Grafana version. In the older version, it was available as default already. That means that you don't need to install or configure it. You simply launch Grafana, and you should have seen in the past, like there's a green data source icon with test DB or test data. So this is what test data is, and it is basically all fake data. The whole idea of using it is to, for example, if you are new to Grafana or if you want to explore Grafana and see like the new options, you can use this data source and mock its data even and see like what kind of different visualization you can get. There is a whole page of its documentation which exactly says same, and I will put that link in the description below so you can check it out. And but here today we're gonna take a look more in more practical approach so that how we can use it. So the first thing we will see or discuss is how to install test data and also how to import existing database. So let's take a look into it. So I have my Grafana running and I just log in with the default login credentials. So right now I do not have anything, right? And if I go here and click a new dashboard and add visualization, you see I have no data source. But I do have some options here like discover visualization using mock data and a few others. So this is the one a bit interesting, and here you see like I clicked it and I see a mock data. So this is a small representation of test data, but this is not exactly the test data source. Also it giving some options about some mock data like random walk, live measurement and public files. But to really use and install test data, we need to first configure it and install it on our local machine. So I will discard it, remove, and I will go into administration and I go in plugins. And here I will type just test, and yeah, you should see something like test data. And I said that this is already showing that it is installed by it is installed because it is installed by default by the system, and it's the core plugin of Grafana. So it is available on every Grafana version, but it is maybe not visible to you unless you enable it correctly. So what we're gonna do next is that now it is available, I will just simply click here, and now I will click on add new data source. Now data source is added and I need to just configure it. So I will name it as test data. The setup remains same. I don't do anything here. But in dashboard, I do have an option to import it. So basically here I have an option to import it, and it will import a simple streaming example, which looks very fancy by the name. So let's try it out. So it says that dashboard has imported successfully, and we can save and test it, and it will say data source is working, and it should be, because there is really no real data, it's all fake data, and there is no real endpoint to it. It's all part of the core for testing purpose and to explore Grafana, to explore different options. So yeah, so let's go back to the dashboards. And in general, if I click on general folder, I now see a dashboard named simple streaming example, and this is the one which we just imported it. So let's click on it, and now you see that, oh, this is really cool. I have a very running and very fancy dashboard which looks like a real live streaming. And that's it is it is about showing how you can stream view the stream data in Grafana, and it gives you some random values. But this is all fake, but it's a good way to see like Grafana has such capabilities to support such live streaming as well. Excuse me. Now what we're gonna do is that we have this streaming example setup already imported. We will create some new dashboard. So we go here and click a new dashboard, and we click add visualization. Now you should see that I have now a new data source called test data, and this is currently the default because there is nothing exist on the system. And let's click on it, and now you see that I get the same data representation, which is a fake one, which I get when I even have not configured. But this time I have a actual data source, scenarios, and a whole bunch of options in the query editor. So right now this is random walk. So what it means that it will generate a random data. So if I click fresh here, it will change. And right now we are doing it in time series. So what we also can do is that we can switch to the table view. To switch to the table view while remain in time series, you click on this toggle button, and now you see time and the series value. So right now it's 27 mostly, here is 26, but refresh it again while remaining 6 hours. It doesn't matter what time picker you choose. This is called time picker, but we don't need to go deep right now on this. We will cover this later. And now the value in the refresh is not changed. Now it's around 80s. Okay, now let's refresh again, and the time is also changing and the value changing, and this is all coming from random data. So this is the purpose of random data, is to mock data, do something to show you, and you can play around and see like how different values look in different area. This is for the time series, but we can also use like bar chart. Maybe not very good example, but at least there is some data which is showing up. It's too much stack, so but still there are values, and it is changing on every refresh. And you can play around with different visualization. Please let me know if any of the visualization may not work with you. We'd like to know, and we can discuss it out. Maybe it is supported, or maybe it's a bug. So it's a good test learning for you as well. And let me know. Now we switch, we keep the test data, but we move to the scenario of different options. So here you can see different options. So even before going into this, I will go back to the documentation, and this is what exactly what we have just discussed. Here in the documentation it's tell about the introduction, how to configure it, which we just did, and then choosing a scenario. And these are the list of available scenarios. For example, here you can see random walk. There are some more with random walk with errors or with tables and so on. So there is a big list of it. So let's try to see some other scenarios. So the one which I really like is called CSV file. What it does is that now I have a scenario of a CSV file. I select one of these files here, so I want to select flight info by state, and I can see the data in visualization. And let's suppose I select time series, and now it's giving me an option that I have either switched to table or open visualization suggestion. So if I go to the table, the table will be selected here and I can see this data in a table format. But maybe this is not something I'm so much fan of and I want to see in a visualized format. So what I will do, as I was here, I click on table and I select on suggestions, and now I see more options how to visualize my data. So for example, I want to see it in a bar chart, and this is what I will get. So this is the information about flights to different cities or countries. Similarly, we can check about browser market share CSV data. So this is what we have, maybe not looking so fancy. Again, we go in suggestions and we can see it better in pie chart. And this looks really much better that in browser market, Chrome as a fake data, for example, is 50% popular than IE, Firefox, Safari, and so on. So this is the whole purpose of test data. There is also one more option which you can use in test data, for example, is to use random walk. We discussed random walk with errors. In this case, we have to change the visualization maybe to time series, and then it should work. Okay. Seems like we found a small error that if we change the scenario, and even though we select the wrong visualization, so in the first attempt it shows an error, but in second it still does not go away. So I will definitely report this to our engineering, and yeah, we'll try to get it fixed. So we have discussed CSV file as well. So there is also CSV metric value. So this is also something really cool, which I also use a lot. So for example, right now we have again selected time series, and we have here an option called string input, right? What it does is that it gives an option to provide different sort of string values. So for example, 0, then I say the next is 100, but then the next is 50, then 100 again, then 10, then 20, then 30, and so on. So this is getting plotted on the run, and this is really cool to again show your data, test it out, understand how the visualization work for your data, and you can still filter, play around with more. So you can go again, this is coming in time series, but you can go in suggestions. And you can do some more fancy stuff. For example, you can create bar chart, or you can go this one is I think called bar chart with gradient color, so it provides some gradient color scheme as well. Or you can pull the graph, fill the graph with colors in the area, in the region, and so on. So yeah, this is all about the test data which I want to discuss with you guys. So this is really cool. There are a lot of options which I see that have got added in the recent days. So for example, there is a USA generated data. So this is something, nothing fancy, but it just give you some values, foo, bar, and bus. And you can try out as much as you like. And if something does not work or something which is different from here in the documentation listed, please let me know. I will try to help you and find out maybe if the documentation or the is incorrect or some problem in the Grafana side, and your feedback will be really helpful. So yeah, that's all for today. I really hope that this is small but important session probably been helpful for you to understand how testdb or test data source worked and how you can use it in Grafana to learn it and play with it and understand more better of the options. So yeah, thank you very much, and I hope to see you in the next video. Take care, bye bye.